رسوله الكريم اما بعد فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقده من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Welcome to South Al-Quran. We are doing Juz 18. We are doing short summary. And today we're going to cover Suratul Muminun and Suratul Furqan from ayah number 1 to 20. Let's begin inshallah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Qad aflaha al-mu'minun. No doubt the believers had attained success. Certainly will the believers will succeed. And how they are? They are who are doing their prayers humbly, submissive, and they turn away from ill speech. And what else they do? And they who are observant of zakah, and they who guard their private parts, except from their wives or those their right hand possess, for indeed they will not be blamed. But whoever seeks beyond that, then those are the transgressor, and they are who are of their trust and their promises attentive. And they who are carefully maintain their prayers, they are the inheritors who will inherit the Jannatul Firdaus. They will abide therein eternally. And there's a hadith, you know, it comes whenever you are asking Jannah, ask Allahumma inni asaluka Jannatul Firdaus. Ask for Jannatul Firdaus. Those who are doing their prayers humbly, submissive. Means there's a hadith, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Allah has made five prayers obligatory. If anyone performs ablution for them, well, offer them at the right time and observe perfectly their bowing and submissiveness in them, it is the guarantee of Allah that He will, forgive them, pardon them. And Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he warned us that the first thing to be taken away from Ummah will be khushu, until you will not find it in a single person. So khushu is fear of Allah. So have fear of Allah. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ أَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُورِدُونَ. And they will who turn away from ill speech. So we should turn away from ill speech. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ أَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُورِدُونَ. They turn away from the useless, irrelevant, unnecessary, meaningless action, meaningless conversation and indulgence. They avoid all sorts of things. And وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَعِلُونَ. And it is those who are the observant of zakat, meaning they engage in matter that purify the soul, they engage in action, purify their character, their speech. And it is those who guard their private parts, meaning specially they pure with respect to the sexual behavior, with respect to their sexual pleasure, meaning they only fulfill it through halal way, through their spouse in the right way. Illa ala azwajihim aw ma malakat aymanuhum fa innahum ghayrul mulumin, except from their wives or those their right hand possess, for indeed they will not be blamed. Aw malakat, this is an exceptional situation, okay, the details of which we do not need to do right now, because inshallah it's like, you know, only aw malakat aymanuhum bin ghayrul mulumin. And whoever seeks beyond that, meaning over the seeks a relationship that is beyond what Allah has made lawful, meaning over whoever tries to attain sexual pleasure through the, that is Allah has not allowed, that is haram way, those are the transgressor. Allah is saying they are transgressor. And they who are their trust and their promises attentive, like, you know, whatever amana, whether it's a dog, whether a physical thing, they keep that amana. And those who carefully maintain their prayer, they actually maintain their prayer, you know, they do it on time, the rightfully, and they do it with the conscious. Those are the inheritors. What inheritors? They are inheritors of Jannatul Firdaus. As I mentioned before, we should ask for Jannatul Firdaus. It was narrated from Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is no among you who does not have two abodes, meaning every person has seat that is fixed in two places, one in Jannah and other in Hellfire. So here, and certainly we create man from an extract of clay, and we placed him in a sperm drop in a firm lodging, and we made sperm drop into a clinging clot, and we made a clot into a lump of the flesh, and we made from the lump bones, and we covered the bones with flush, then we develop into the another creation. So here we see the whole formation of the human body is discussed here, and then we developed him into the another creation. So blessed is Allah, the best of the creators. And you know, many scientists and the biologists, they were amazed when they know, like 1400 years ago, it is mentioned in the Quran, and many people, they start believing it, though those who were disbelievers, they got the iman. And then indeed, after that, you are to die. We all have to die. And indeed, you on the day of resurrection will be, we all will be resurrected over there. And here in ayah number 21, وَإِنَّا لَكُمْ فِي الْأَنْعَامِ لَإِبْرَةٍ. More blessings are mentioned over here. So we recognize our creator. Indeed, for you in livestock is a lesson. We give you drink from that which is in their bellies. And for you in them are numerous benefits. From them you eat. And upon them and on ships you are carried. And we have certainly sent Nuh alayhi salam to his people. And he said, O my people, worship Allah and have no deity other than him. Then will you not fear him? You know, Allah is asking, will you not fear? And here in ayah number 26, Nuh alayhi salam said, O my Lord, Rabbi ansurni bima kazzabuni. O my Lord, support me because they have denied me. He worked for 950 years and still they denied. So we inspired him. So Nuh alayhi salam, he constructed the ship under the observation of who? Under the observation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah command how it should be, and he commanded to go and overflow, and you know, ship was overflowing with the water. Put into the ship from each creature two mates, and you know all the creatures, they were two mates, and family also, except those for them the decree of destruction has proceed. And do not address me concerning those who have wronged. Here about whom it's talking about? Those people who were drowned in the water because they don't believe it. When you have boarded ship and you those with you, then say, Alhamdulillah allazi najana min alqawmi zalimin. Say praise to Allah who has saved us from the wrongdoing people. وَخُلْ رَبِّ أَنزِلْنِي مُنزَلًا مُبَارَكًا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْمُنزَلِينَ. This is a beautiful dua. Say, O my Lord, let me land at the blessed landing place and you are the best to accommodate. So inshallah, we can also, when we go someplace, we can recite this dua. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتِ وَإِنَّا كُنَّا مُبْتَلِينَ. Indeed, in that signs are indeed, we are ever testing. And here in later we see ayah number 37, they said, life is not but our worldly life. We only live here. We die and we live, but will we not be resurrected? So they are thinking, you know, they won't be resurrected. That's their iman. Then we produce after them our other generation. It means so many generation has been produced later on. And summa arsalna rusuluna tathra, and then we send our messengers in succession, and every time they come to a nation, its messenger, they denied. So we made them follow one another in destruction, and we made them narrations. Waja'alnahum ahadith. We made them narration, means so away with the people who do not believe. And here in ayah number 49, walaqad atayna Musa al-kitab, and we certainly gave Musa al-Islam the scriptures. Perhaps they would be guided, talking about Bani Israel. And here, and we made the son of Maryam, Isa al-Islam, and his mother Maryam a sign. We sheltered them with high ground, having level areas and flowing water. This was the given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya ayyuhar rusul. Allah said, O messengers, command was given to all the prophets. Okay. And kulu minat tayyibati wa amilu salihan. Eat from the good food and work righteous. Inni bima ta'amaluna alim. And indeed, I of what you do, knowing. So here, wa inna hazihi. And indeed, this is your religion, is the one religion, and I am Lord, I am your Lord, so fear me. Wa inna hazihi ummatukum ummatum wahida. وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَاتَّقُونِي. I'm your Lord, so fear me. So we have to fear only Allah, subhanallah ta'ala. أُولَٰئِكَ يُسَارِئُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ. Ayah number 61. It is those who hasten to good deeds. They are the one who rush in doing good deeds. They do not delay. وَهُمْ لَا سَابِقُونَ and they outstrip others therein. So what is that goes ahead in good doing? They performing good deeds and they do it. مِنْ خَشْيَةِ رَبِّهِمْ مُشْفِقُونَ who are afraid of their Rabb. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِآيَاتِهِ رَبِّهِمْ يُؤْمِنُونَ they believe in the signs of the verses of the Lord. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِرَبِّهِمْ لَا يُشْرِكُونَ those who do not associate anything with their Lord. وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتُوا and who give that they give while their hearts are fearful. Aisha رضي الله عنها asked Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم about this ayat. She said, Ya Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, are these the one that steal and commit zina and drink alcohol while fearing Allah? Meaning who are disobeying Allah while they are disobeying, they are afraid. وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتُوا she said, is it the people who are sinning or who are doing haram? So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, no, O daughter of Siddiq, they are the one who pray and fast and give in charity while fearing that it will not be accepted from them. Ulaika yusariuna fil khairat, those are the ones who hasten in doing good and they outstrips other than in. And ulaika yusariuna khairat wa hum la sabiqun. And here later on we see in ayah number 72, tasa'aluhum, why do they reject Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Is it because you ask them for payment? No, but the reward of your Lord is with the best. He is the best of the provider. Any prophet, any Rasul, they are not asking any wage from the people. Only that is given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and that He is the best of the best provider. But people still, they are not accepting the message. And until when we have opened before them a door of severe punishment, immediately they will be there in despair. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts us through difficulties in this life. Why? So that we humble ourselves before Allah, we think of Him, we return to Him, we pray to Him, we remember Him. But what happened? Many people, despite going through the ups and downs in life, they don't turn away. Like they don't turn to Allah. Why? Because of, deluded by the worldly things, or they have, maybe they are mistaken by giving the worldly things, And even though they are going through some calamity, still they don't understand that. And it is who has multiplied you throughout the earth, and to Him you will be gathered. Inshallah, we all will be gathered to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in ayah number 93, O Rabbi imma turiyani, say, O Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, my Lord, you should show me that which they are promised. Meaning, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was still in Makkah right now. And the people were refusing to believe. So he was afraid that if they are following the way of people of Nuh, the people of Lut, what's going to happen? The punishment is unavoidable. Still he is so concerned about that. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was very apprehensive about that. So say, my Lord, if you should show me the punishment which they are promised, meaning if it happens in my life, then what? So he is so concerned about them. And my Lord, then do not place me among the wrongdoing people. And indeed we are able to show you what we have promised them. And repel by means of what is best their evil, we most knowing of what they describe. اِدْفَى بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ سَيِّئَةَ نَحْنُ عَالَمُ بِمَا يَسِفُونَ. And here in ayah number 98, وَأَعُوذُ بِكَ رَبِّي أَنْ يَحْضُرُونَ. There's a قُلْ رَبِّي أَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ حَمَزَاتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ وَأَعُوذُ بِكَ رَبِّي أَنْ يَحْضُرُونَ. Ayah number 97 and 98. And say, O my Lord, I seek refuge in you from the incitements of devil. Because this is the, devils incite you, but if you should recite this dua, inshallah, Allah will save you. And seek refuge in you from my Lord, lest they present with me. Meaning, they can inspire. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he got up to pray at night, he he would say Allahu Akbar Takbir, and then he would say Subhanakallahumma bihamdika la ilaha illallah Allahu Akbar, and then he would say this also, A'udhu billahi samiul alim minash shaitan rajim min hamzihi wa nafthihi wa nafsi, this dua also, that I seek refuge in Allah, all hearing, all knowing, from cursed devil and from his evil suggestion, from his puffing up, from his spitting. So we should also make dua, inshallah. And here we see later in this ayah number 103, وَمَنْ قَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ, and but whoever deeds are light, the scales are light, those are the ones who have lost their souls, being in hell, abiding eternally. The fire will sear their faces and they will have taut smiles, and it will be said, we were not my verses recited to you, you used to deny them. You know, that time they realized, قَالُوا رَبَّنَا غَلَبَتْ عَلَيْنَا شِقْوَتُنَا, they will say, our Lord, our wretchedness overcame us, and we were the people of astray. Our Lord, remove us from it, and if we were to return to evil, we would indeed be wrongdoers. He will say, remain despite therein, and do not speak to me. Allah is saying, do not speak to me now. Because what happened, indeed there was a party of my servant who said, our Lord, we have believed, so forgive us and have mercy on us. You are the best of the merciful. But you took them in mockery. You made fun of those believed people. The point they made, you forget my remembrance, and you used to laugh at them because of their arrogance and, you know, making fun of the deen. So now they are being charged now. And قُلْ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ وَارْحَمْ أَنْتَ خَيْرُ الرَّاحِمِينَ, and say, O my Lord, forgive and have mercy, you are the best of the merciful. This is in ayah number 118. Just, it's a short dua, inshallah, if you memorize it, it's really a good dua. And here, inshallah, we'll start Suratul Noor. And here, Suratul Noor, mashallah, it's a beautiful surah, and we learn so much ahkamat in that. Surat, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Suratun anzalnaha wa faradnaha wa anzalna fiha ayatin bayyinatin la'allakum tazakkaroon. This is the surah which we have sent down. Who sent down the surah? Who has revealed it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa faradnaha, and we have made it obligatory. Allah made it obligatory. Allah has wa anzalnaha fiha ayatin bayyinat, and we have revealed their verses of clear evidence. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ, that you might remember. Here, الزَّانِيَةُ الزَّانِيَةَ فَجْلِدْ كُلَّ وَاحِدًا مِّنْهُمَا مِيَةَ جَلْدًا, and the unmarried woman or the unmarried man found guilty of sexual intercourse, meaning outside of the marriage, lash each one of them with 100 lashes, and do not take by piety for them in the religion of Allah, if you should believe in Allah and the last day, and let group of the believer witness this punishment. So those watching also will take the lesson. Reality is that, you know, zina is unlawful sexual intercourse. This is an evil action, because firstly, it is the height of immodesty. It is the, you know, it is a source of much evil for the individual who are involved in it and the communities that they live in. And Allah has declared zina is unlawful. You know, it is something that is not permissible, which we learn that zina do not coexist with iman. Meaning, if zina is, one is doing zina, he is out of the iman. So he don't have iman anymore. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, from among the signs of hour are the following, religious knowledge will be taken away. And the secondly, ignorance will prevail. Third, drinking of alcohol, drink will become common. And the fourth, there will be a prevalence of open illegal sexual intercourse, that is zina. So we have to be careful. And we learn from another hadith, he said, two men came to me, okay, he was shown a vision while he was sleeping, and held my arm and took me to a very difficult mountain. This happened when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was at Miraj. In this case, over there were some people whose bodies had terribly swollen. There were people whose bodies had become swollen, and from there he was going there, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to know why they are being punished, because of the committing illegal sexual intercourse, that is zina. So fornicator does not marry except a female fornicator or polytheist. Okay, meaning a man who commits zina, he should only marry a woman who was like him. Or he should marry a woman who not even a Muslim. What does this mean? Means he should not allow to marry a chaste or pure believing woman who guards her modesty, who preserves her chastity. No, he should be paired with her and none marries her except a fornicator or a polytheist. Likewise, in other side also that if woman is like that, you know, she should not marry a man who is a chaste. That has been made lawful to the believers. Meaning when it is clear that someone is a zani, it is known that the person has committed zina, then such marriages should not take place. Why? Why should a pure, chaste person be married to a fornicator? This is injustice, isn't it? And it will lead to many, many problems. And those who accuse chaste women then do not produce four witnesses. We can't accuse chaste women. Meaning a person who accuses a woman of zina that, this woman, this girl, this lady, she was committed zina. They don't bring four witnesses. Then who is the criminal? The one who is accusing. Lash them with 80 lashes and do not accept from its testimony ever after. That those are the defiantly disobedient, except for those who repent thereafter and reform, for indeed Allah is forgiving and merciful. And those who accuse their wives for adultery have no witness except themselves. Then witness of one of them shall be four testimonies, swearing by Allah that indeed he is of the truthful. And the fifth oath will be the curse of Allah be upon if he should be among the liars. You know, you don't have any witness and you have been blamed, whether it's a husband or wife. They have to take the oath, and if they are lying, whoever is lying, the curse will be on them. But it will prevent punishment from her if she gives four testimonies swearing by Allah that indeed he is of the liars. And the fifth oath will be the wrath of Allah be upon her if he was of the truthful. You know, it's an easy thing. Some women, they start lying, and you know, even though they committed mistake, they don't say in front of husband. They think it's okay to lie and they started doing it. And Allah will open the worldly things for them in this world, but Allah will catch one day in this world and also in the hereafter. They have to be careful, whether woman or man. You know, when they are asking and when you are taking oath, make sure that you don't lie. Okay? And here in ayah number 11, indeed those who came with falsehood are a group among you. Inna allazeena ja'ul bil ifki usbatum minkum. They are the group among you. They are the ones who made of this lie. Do not think it's bad for you, rather it's good for you. For every person among them is what punishment he has earned from the sin. He took upon himself the greater portion thereof. For them is a great punishment. These verses are about the incident of ifk. The following ayah, these verses are about the incident of ifk, means a lie. So the incident of the great lie, what was a great lie? This happened in the time of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. When once on a journey which was at Ghazwa Banu Mustalik, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was going in a particular expedition. And whenever he would go on expedition, he would take him some of his wives, you know. So this time Aisha Radhiyallahu Anha was accompanied with him. And when she went on the journey, in the battle, she was going with him, and she took somebody's necklace she borrowed, and she was wearing that necklace, and she went. So, returned from the journey back to Medina, back home, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he had the Muslims rest for the sometimes and over there. And Aisha Radhiyallahu Anha, she got off of her camel and she went to use the restroom. And when she returned to sit back on the camel, she realized that her necklace was missing. So she went back in order to look for it, and she went for a while, she couldn't find it. But eventually what happened, when she returned, she saw that everybody had left. Because when they came, they took her camel and they probably didn't ask, they didn't have conversation. So, and she was very lightweighted, so they didn't realize and they started walking. So Aisha Radhiyallahu Anha, she stayed over there. She just lied down over there and she was asleep. And then one Sahaba, he was appointed and he has to look for the things which are, whatever is missing, or he will look after, you know. So Aisha radhiyallahu anha, she stayed over there until evening. Like, you know, eventually one companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came by. It was his duty to stay behind the caravan to look after the things, you know. And when he saw Aisha radhiyallahu anha was sleeping, he said, Inna lillahi wa inna ilaihi rajiun, loudly, because this is the wife of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She has been left behind. So what happened? Aisha radhiyallahu anha, she sat on the camel and he brought her to the Medina. Now they came in when Abdullah bin Ubay, he was the munafiq. And he was angry with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam because of certain things what happened, you know. And then this, he started, you know, accusing. He started putting the rumors, you know, when meaning he accused Aisha radhiyallahu anhu that Nazbillah, she committed zina, and what happened, he just however spread in the whole Medina. And Aisha radhiyallahu anhu, when she reached Medina, she fell ill. She fell very ill. And she was ill for an entire month. And during the whole time, she had no idea what happened, what they are talking about. But she noticed that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not the way he used to be. Always there was something different over here. She could feel that, you know, something strange going on. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam never confronted her even once. He would come and, you know, see how she was doing, spend some time with her and go. But she knew that something was not right. Eventually, Aisha radiallahu anhu find out what has happening. She cried so much that her tears did not stop. All night long, she wept and wept. And then when she asked Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam if she could go to her parents' house, she went to her and he said, okay. And until this point, she had not even confronted the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay. Because she don't know what to do. She was like in a shock. So she went to her parents and her mother said that, oh Aisha, every wife who is loved by husband, people are jealous of her, and so don't worry. This is just a people, a jealousy, it will go, you know. But Aisha radhiyallahu anha, she cried a lot, and eventually what happened, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to see her. And he said to her that, you know, if you are innocent, then Allah will reveal your innocence. Who is saying? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And if something wrong has happened, then just ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what does it prove? Like, you know, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he does not know ghaib. Okay? He's just seeing the things as a husband. You know, if you are innocent, Allah will reveal the ayah. So you don't need to cry. If you have done something wrong, then ask forgiveness. So what happened and after this, and she, the days were going on, and Aisha radhiyallahu anha said that in her tears just dried up, and Ansari woman, she came to see Aisha and she cried, and both of them cried. And then eventually we see that Aisha was sitting radhiyallahu anha. At this time Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was there, Abu Bakr was there, and the mother is there, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah, establishing the Aisha radhiyallahu anha's innocence. Indeed, those who came with falsehood, a group among you, do not think it bad for you. Just imagine so much pain Prophet sallallahu alaihi himself is went through, and because of Aisha did not know for entire month, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam knew for him to have sabr, and she's unwell, and he didn't disturb because she is already sick. And Allah says, don't think it bad for you. This fact is, no matter what happens in our life, like, you know, Allah is consoling the heart. For every person among them is the punishment what he has earned from the sin. He who took up himself the greater portion thereof, for him a greater punishment. You know, whoever spreading the rumors and so on. So we learned that, you know, for the time being, it was really hard for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Aisha radhiyallahu anhu, she has gone through so much, but she did sabr like a sabrun jameel, like Yaqub alaihi wasallam did the beautiful sabr, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayahs and honored her. Why when you heard it did not believing men and women think good of one another? So this is a lesson over here, you know, when you hear something, some falsehood, don't spread the rumors, you know. Why did this whose land did not produce it for it for witness? When they do not produce the witness, then it they the sight of Allah who are the liars. And here we learn in ayah number 15, when you receive it with your tongue, you said with your mouth that of which you have no knowledge. When you receive it with your tongue, said your mouth of that which you had no knowledge. Your thought is insignificant while it was a sight of Allah. It's a tremendous, you know, lying the people. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a man utters a word pleasing to Allah without considering it of any significance for which Allah exalt his rank in Jannah. But another person speaks a word displeasing to Allah without considering it of an important, and for this reason he will sink down into the hell. So we have to be careful what we are doing. And here later we see in ayah number 20, وَلَوْ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتُهُ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ رَؤُوفُ الرَّحِيمُ. And if he had not been for the favor of Allah upon you and his mercy, and because Allah is kind and merciful. And here in ayah number 22, and let not those of virtue among you and wealth swear not to give aid to their relatives and the needy and the immigrants for the cause of Allah. Let them forgive and overlook. Would you not like that Allah should forgive you? Allah is forgiving and merciful. This ayah number 22, we learn that one of the companion, he was a sincere believer. He made an honest mistake over here. What was that? That he was one of the people who spread the slander against Aisha radiallahu anha, meaning he heard it from Abdullah bin Ubay and he started doing the rumors. And you see here people, Abu Bakr Siddiq, He was helping this person financially. But when he came to know, he was really very hurt and, you know, he stopped giving it. So, and in this ayah, he was commanded that, you know, forgive and overlook and still give the money. So, and after that, he increased the money and he started giving it. So, we all should fear Allah. People may do mistake, but we have to overlook. Indeed, those who falsely accuse chaste, unaware and believing women are cursed in this world and the hereafter. They will have a great punishment. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if somebody slander his slave and his slave is free in what he says, then this not a slander of zina could be falsely accused or stole. You did this without my permission. And generally this happened that, you know, servants are playing children or so on. So this is not a good thing. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if a slave is free from what he says, meaning he is innocent, then he will be flogged on the day of resurrection. The person who is spreading the rumors. And 26 ayah, al-khabisatu lil-khabisina wal-khabisuna lil-khabaisat. Evil words are for evil men. And meaning evil words, they don't befit clean people, isn't it? Good people don't say bad words about them. And evil men are subjected to evil words. And good words are for the good men. And the good men are subject for the good words. Those good people are declared innocent. What the slanders for them is forgiven and noble provision. And here we see later in ayah number 30, tell the believing men to reduce some of their vision, lower their gaze, and guard their private part. قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَقْضُوا مِنْ أَبْسَارِهِمْ وَيَحْفَزُونَ فُرُوجَهُمْ. They should lower their gaze and guard their private part. That is purer for them and Allah is acquainted what they do. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, three kinds of eyes will not see the fire of the day of judgment. The eye that weeps from the fear of Allah, that is one, and the eye guards in the way of Allah, and the meaning stay awake guarding the way of Allah. So we should prohibit our eyes from, you know, we should always fear Allah. And in another hadith we learn Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Ali radiallahu anhu that do not give a second look, Ali. No, first look, you know, by mistake it happens. And وَالْقُلْ مُؤْمِنَاتِ يَغْدُدْنَا مِنْ أَبْسَارِهِنْ. And tell the believing women to reduce some of their vision. So, you know, by mistake you see, but, you know, you can't start looking and, you know, admiring nahmahram people, guarding their private parts, and they should not expose their adornment except in which necessary. So here in ayah number 31, this is very important ayah, meaning they should not look admiring non-mahram people and lower their gaze. You see, sins have consequences, and guard their private parts. And here we see, وَلَا يُبْدِينَ زِينَتَهُنَّ إِلَّا مَا زَهَرَ مِنْهَا, meaning a woman beauty, which is her beauty, her clothes, her hair, she should not expose to the people who are just going to enjoy it and then move on. No, your body is for you. It's for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given that amana. It's not for the people's pleasure. It is for the enjoyment. And that is, you can have husband and wife and mahram rishta only in front of them. But here, like for example, for a woman, if she even meant to cover their hands, her feet and every part of her body so that her skin is not even exposed, even an inch, she can't do the right. Likewise, her height, I mean the height is beautiful, isn't it? But here, woman itself is a beautiful. But here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whatever illa ma zahara minna, means a woman is wearing beautiful clothes and she has something on top to cover it. But then she walks like wind blow a little and, you know, it is seen. That's okay. Okay? It doesn't mean, and sometimes, you know, your hands are exposed because you're not wearing gloves, or sometimes your bangles are, that's okay. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the worst of your women are those who are decked out, who are displaying adornment, like when they go out, they dress up in order to attract attention. And this hadith says those who walk and pretense also. And also it says, you know, the people who red-beaked and footed crow, like, you know, you are tapping your feet and walking and so on. And they should wrap a portion of their head covers over their chest. Well, yadribna bi khumirihinna ala juyubihin. Here, khumur is from khimar, and here, covering. Ala juyubihin is on the bosom, is on the chest. You have to cover your chest head scarf, as well as cover your chest properly. And this is a hukum, which is mentioned about, you know, how when you go out, you have to cover yourself. People start arguing, you know, where is there? We have to wear abaya or long coat or covering ourselves. It is the ahkamat given in Suratul Nur and Suratul Ahzab, and particularly this ayah number 31. And they should not expose their adornment except to the husband, father, husband's father, and meaning father-in-law. Their sons, their husband's sons, meaning steps, and their brother's sons, their sister's sons, meaning their nephews, their women, and that which their right hand possesses, or those male attendants having no physical desire. You know, they don't know about, they don't have that capacity. Or children who are not yet aware of the private aspects of women. Like, you know, they are still little. Let them not stamp their feet to make known that they conceal of their adornment. You know, you walk in such a manner, even though you cover yourself, you're stamping your feet, everybody will look at you. And turn to Allah in repentance, all of you who believe. So here we see, like, you know, after doing all this, still have repentance. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا, you know, do tawbah, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, so that you will be successful. We have seen from قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, and here again, this Suratul Nur, where we end the ayah, here also we see مُفْلِحُونَ, and then later on we see, inshallah, we'll end here, in ayah number 41, we see أَلَمْ تَرَى أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُزْبِهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَلَنْ. Do you not see that Allah is exalted by whoever within the heaven and earth by the words with wings spread in flight? And each of them has known his means of prayer and exalt him. Allah is knowing of what you do. And here in the Suratul Nur, we learn so many ahkamat here. And here in the end of the ayah, we see in ayah number 64, Allah inna Allahi ma fis samawati walad, unquestionably to Allah belongs whatever is in heaven and earth. قَدْ يَعْلَمُ مَا أَنْتُمْ عَلَيْهِ, already he knows that upon which you stand. He will know the day when they will return to him, and he will inform them of what they have done, and Allah is knowing of all things. Suratul Furqan, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ الْفُرْقَانَ عَلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ لِيَكُونَ لِلْعَالَمِينَ نَزِيرًا. Blessed is he who sent down the criterion, is the Quran, upon his servant, who, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he may be to the worlds a warner. And here then, but they have taken besides him, shirk, you know. And those who disbelieve say the Quran is not except a falsehood. And he has invented the falsehood. And here they say legends of the former people, you know, they say fable tales. Say Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in response to all this as accusation, it has been revealed by he who knows every secret within the heaven and earth. And here in ayah number 10, Tabarakallazi, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is comforted here. Blessed is the meaning who he will could have made for you something better than that. The people say that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has not been given a garden and so on and so forth. Allah says he could have given you something better than they demand, garden beneath which river flows and could make you for your palaces. And here in ayah number 17, and mention the day he will gather them and that which they worship beside Allah. And he will say, did you mislead this my servants, and they themselves stay away from me? So on the day of judgment, even the false god which they are associating will be asked. And here in ayah number 20, and we did not send before, O Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, any of the messenger except what they ate food and walked in the markets. So, and we have made some of you people as a trial for others. Will you have patience? وَجَعَلْنَا بَعْدُكُمْ لِبَعْدٍ فِتْنَةً أَتَصْبِرُونَ. So you have patience. وَكَانَ رَبُّكَ بِسَبْصِيرًا, and ever is your Lord seeing. There is a hadith regarding that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the believer who mix with the people and bear their annoyance with the patience will have a greater reward than the believer who do not mix with the people and does not put their annoyance. So there is a, and here, Allahumma ja'alni sabura, make dua with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika, nashadu Allah ilaha illa anta nasta.